I'm so happy that Jack Miller and Janet Wasko asked me to speak to all of you about the Baptist Homes, my home. I am a licensed practical nurse, and over the years, I have visited very many homes, but also thought Baptist Homes was the best. And now I live here, I know that's true. I was on the waiting list for the Baptist Manor for almost 3 years. When we got the call that the apartment was available, I moved to the apartment on December 13, 1996. My lucky number always was 13. There are 100 apartments, and Carol Fierce is the leader of us all. Carol has called me mommy for many years, and this is why I tell everybody she is my adopted daughter. God love her. In the manor, we had all kinds of activities. Most of all, I had started. We had brown bag lunch, where everyone brings their lunch and we eat together. I have a funny story. We had a gentleman who brought his brown bag, but it was empty. I told him we would have to help him this time, but next time he needs to have something in his brown bag. Everyone gave him something from their lunch so that he could eat with us. In the manor, we had lots of fun. We had plays and we made our own costumes, and it was like a second family. I lived in the manor for 14 years. In late 2010, I was diagnosed with cancer and underwent surgery to remove the cancer and several lymph nodes. I have always had sensitivity to medications, so it took a while for me to get the right medication for me. I was in and out of intensive care at McGee Hospital and in St. Clair, and finally came to Baptist Homes Nursing Center. After several months in the nursing center, I was well enough to be discharged, but not well enough to go back to my apartment in the manor. It was then, in early 2011, that I have offered a room in Baptist Homes personal care. You know, when you get older, your bones get a little brittle. Now, one day, when the personal care aides were turning me over in the bed, trying to put the pump on my legs. I fractured the right hip. Off to the hospital for more surgery. I was discharged this time to Providence Point for rehab because there were no beds available at Baptist Homes. Providence Point was beautiful and received wonderful care, but my home was really Baptist Homes personal care, and I couldn't wait to get back. For years, my nephew had donated to Samaritan Fund. Thanks to the generosity of so many others, I have been able to live in the personal care at Baptist Homes for the last 5 years. I thank y'all for having me as a speaker for the delicious dinner. And I just want to end by saying I am still in the Baptist Homes after 20 years and wouldn't want to be anywhere else. Thank you.